Okay, here we are at TechCon, and I'm with who?
I'm Ollie, I'm from Undo Software.
Okay, what the heck is Undo Software?
So we make a reversible debugger, which allows you to record the execution of your program and then literally run the program backwards.
So why is that important?
So it means literally no more lost bugs. You know, you run a program forwards and it goes horribly wrong and you have no idea why. And with us, you can literally rewind and watch the bug happen backwards, step by step, and see it all raveling back. You can run it forwards again and backwards until you really pinpoint the bug. It makes it a lot quicker to get to the sort of the crux of the problem. Okay. and much simpler.
Okay, who else does this?
So GDB, which is the GNU debugger, uh-huh, has a process record function that records it, but unfortunately they do it very crudely and they can slow your program down something like...
What do they do, swear at you?
Yeah, exactly. No, they literally snapshot every line of your code. And so your program that might have taken, you know, 1 second to run, it can sometimes slow down up to 50,000 times.
Okay.
With us, slow down sometimes somewhere between 1.7 times and four times.
Okay.
So that's sort of typical.
How much does it cost?
So we're $1,800 for a single user or single concurrent user.
Okay.
For a year.
Great. Thank you.
Awesome. Thanks very much.
Okay, here we are at the Tordex booth at Arm TechCon, and I'm talking to who?
Samuel, hey, so I'm Samuel, I'm the head of the Seattle office here in the US, and I would like to quickly walk you through our ARM computer module platform. What we have is a so-called Calibri module. It's a modular ARM PC or computer module, and we have a whole family. They're all pin compatible, so you can upgrade and downgrade between modules.
Why is that important?
Well, if you do your custom carrier board design, so this is a carrier board, this could be as well maybe in a medical device. So a next generation device, you might want to recycle your carrier board, but you want more performance. You maybe want to put in a dual core or quad core ARM CPU. We have the same module form factor on a high performance platform. So all you do, you keep your carrier board and you're actually going to plug in another module. So you can take any of those modules and they will plug right in. So I could take this as an NVIDIA Tegra 3. Quad core, it goes in the same IO form factor, plugs in, and there you go. That's a hardware and software upgrade in your same existing platform.
And no one else can do that?
There's different form factors out there, like Q7 or maybe like Com Express. What's unique about our form factor is it's very small. This is an SOD module, like a memory module for your laptop. Mm-hmm. And the other really important factor is what kind of software support do you get from a computer module vendor? So we provide you Windows CE, Linux and Android OS for all our modules, and you get the support through the same vendor that sells you the hardware. So that's important because your software development team and your hardware development team is talking to the same people, and you can actually access our development resources if you want to have some help in driver development or maybe some debugging help. It's the same company. You don't have to go through a BSP company, which will charge you all the development fees for that.
Okay.
So that's a good value in terms of what you're getting from an entire embedded computer platform.
Okay.
Yeah.
Great.
Thank you.
Thank you very much, Sam.
Yeah.
Bye-bye. Okay, here I am at the Somnium booth at Arm TechCon, and I'm talking to who?
I'm Dave Edwards, the founder and CTO of Somnium Technologies.
Okay, and what the heck do you guys do?
We produce a software tools product called DART, D-R-T, which we're announcing here today. Supporting in the first edition Freescale Kinetics microcontrollers based on ARM Cortex. We have some very interesting new technology in here, which we call device-aware resequencing.
Okay.
Conventionally, in code generation tools, the compiler is just aware of the underlying processor. With DART, the tools are aware of the actual device, the coupling of the processor to the memory system. This allows us to automatically generate a highly efficient, very optimal program. The result of it is the programs are significantly smaller, generally about 20% smaller than with other technologies. Slightly higher performance, better energy behavior, more deterministic.
What other technologies are there?
There are other whole program optimization technologies available, but they're not really suited to embedded systems. They require dynamic feedback. The DART technology is entirely automatic, completely compatible with existing source code, no changes required.
Okay. And what are some of the better applications for it?
It's compatible with all GNU-compatible C and C++ source code. We use a large variety of synthetic benchmarks and industry standard test suites. We get some really great results. We're members of Embassy as well. We'll be officially publishing some results later in the year as part of our general availability. We're on beta release at the moment for Freescale Kinetis controllers. So if you look at www.somniumtech.com, you can register to join our beta program. And we'll be releasing to support a wider range of ARM-based devices in the near future.
Excellent. Thank you.
Thank you very much.